What is up, everyone, and welcome back to Ton Does Linux and More. It's been another absolutely packed week in the Linux world, and you know what that means? We've got a ton of exciting news to break down, from a brand new look for one of the most popular desktop environments, to a distro that's making some seriously smart moves, and even some love for floppy disks? Yeah, you heard that right. So grab your coffee, get comfortable, and let's dive into the biggest Linux news from the past week. All right, let's kick things off with the heart of our systems, the Linux kernel. It's been a busy week for kernel developers with a flurry of security updates rolling out. Red Hat, SUSE, and Ubuntu have all pushed out important patches to address multiple vulnerabilities. So as always, make sure you're keeping your systems updated, folks. It's your first line of defense, but it's not only just about security patches. Looking ahead, we're already seeing some exciting developments for Linux 6.18. The kernel is getting ready to support the ASPDE AST2700 BMC. Now, for those of you who don't know, BMCs, or baseboard management controllers, are little computers on a chip that let you manage servers remotely. This is a big deal for the data center and enterprise world, making Linux even more powerful for managing large-scale infrastructure. And now for something a little different. In a blast from the past, the floppy disk driver code got some love this week. Yes, you heard me right. Floppy disks. While most of us haven't touched a floppy in years, it's a testament to the Linux kernel's commitment to supporting a wide range of hardware, both old and new. It's a fun little reminder of how far we've come. Now, let's talk distros, and the big news this week comes from the team at CachyOS. Their August 2025 release is packed with some seriously impressive features. First up is their new package dashboard. This is a fantastic tool for transparency, allowing you to see exactly where your packages are coming from, whether it's the official Arch repos, the AUR, or Cachy's own modified packages. You can even download the binaries directly. It's a great feature for those who like to know what's under the hood. But the CachyOS team isn't just focused on transparency. They're also doubling down on stability. They're now shipping the LTS kernel as a fallback, so if you run into any issues with the latest stable kernel, you can easily roll back to a known good state. The ISO installer is also now using the LTS kernel, which is a smart move to ensure a smooth installation experience for everyone. And for all you BTRFS fans out there, CachyOS now automatically enables bootable snapshots when you choose the GRUD bootloader. This is a lifesaver if an update goes wrong, allowing you to roll back your system to a previous state with ease. It's a feature that we're seeing more and more distros adopt, and for good reason. Of course, CachyOS wasn't the only distro making headlines. MX Linux also released their August snapshots for the KDE and XFCE editions, and Sparky Linux 8.0 was also spotted in the wild. It's great to see so much activity in the distro space. All right, let's move on to the eye candy, our desktop environments and applications. And the big news this week comes from the KDE team. They've just introduced a new feature in Plasma 6.5 called KISS, which stands for KDE Initial System Setup. This is a brand new wizard designed to make it easier than ever to set up a new KDE system, especially for OEM installs. It guides you through user creation, keyboard layout, and time zone selection. It's a great step towards making KDE even more user-friendly. But that's not all for Plasma 6.5. We're also getting scrollable Plasma panels, improved HDR tone mapping, and a more lightweight render loop for KWin, which should give us a nice little performance boost. And for all you gamers out there, the game controller page in system settings is getting an upgrade with more information from SDL. Meanwhile, over in the GNOME camp, the beta for GNOME 49 is out and it's looking slick. One of the most anticipated features is the addition of media controls to the lock screen. This is a small but much requested feature that will make it a lot easier to control your music and videos without having to unlock your computer. We also got a fix for laggy cursors with VRR enabled, which is great news for gamers and anyone with a high refresh rate monitor. And last but not least, the Document Foundation has released LibreOffice 25.8, and it's a massive update. The big focus is on performance, with Writer and Calc now opening files up to 30% faster. They've also overhauled the Microsoft Office interoperability, so you should see fewer formatting issues when working with DOCX, XLSX, and PPTX files. And for all you spreadsheet wizards, there are a ton of new functions in Calc to play with. Next up, let's talk hardware and drivers. And the big news this week comes from Team Green. NVIDIA has released a new Linux driver, version 580.76.05. This update brings better Wayland support, which is great news for those of us who are embracing the future of the Linux desktop. It also includes fixes for Vulkan hangs and some advanced display options for better performance. So, if you're running an NVIDIA card, be sure to grab this update. And for all you gamers out there, there's some exciting news on the horizon. It looks like NVIDIA is working on bringing smooth motion support to the RTX 40 series on Linux. This is a feature that's already available on Windows, and it uses AI to generate intermediate frames for a smoother gaming experience. It's still in development, but it's great to see NVIDIA continuing to invest in the Linux gaming ecosystem. On the AMD side of things, while there were no major driver releases this week, the community is buzzing with benchmarks and comparisons between Windows and Linux performance on the latest AMD hardware. The consensus seems to be that Linux is holding its own, and in some cases, even outperforming Windows in certain games. It's a great time to be a Linux gamer. And now, let's shine a spotlight on the amazing Linux community. It's been a busy week for open source projects, with new releases of VirtualBox, KDE Gear, Firefox, PowerDNS, and FFmpeg. It's a testament to the power of collaboration and the passion of the open source community. On a more serious note, the Arch Linux team has confirmed that they've been dealing with an ongoing DOS attack. This is a reminder that even our most beloved open source projects are not immune to security threats. We're sending our best wishes to the Arch team and hoping for a speedy resolution. And that is a wrap for this week's Linux News Roundup. What a week it's been, from the exciting new features in CachyOS and KDE Plasma to the latest driver updates from NVIDIA, there's never a dull moment in the world of Linux. I hope you found this video informative and helpful. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more Linux content every week. And don't forget to hit that bell icon so you don't miss a single video. What are your thoughts on this week's news? Let me know in the comments below. I love hearing from you guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.